Hello, Onmanorama readers. This is Soumya here, the director of Mangalyam Thanthunanena. Doing a feature film definitely is a massive effort. But the storytelling process, I've told a documentary before. I told a documentary because it is storytelling. It's just that you choose the medium. So I chose a documentary for Chembai. I chose a short film for Rabbit Hole. And with this one, I had to choose a feature film. The medium had to be a feature film because that is what the story demanded. It couldn't be concise to a short film or a documentary. Every story deserves a certain kind of storytelling, and feature film was it. So hence the debut, hence the movie. My film is no different from any other family satire that had been released in Malayalam. So I proudly keep saying it's a very old wine. I'm just packing it in a very fresh, new, exciting looking bottle and wrapping it in a beautiful package and presenting it in front of you. So those of them, the new gen, the newest of the people, I'm wanting to attract them with the wrapper, with the style of the bottle, with the packing. So when you actually open the bottle and you pour it into a glass and taste it, you realize that this I know, I've tasted it before, and this is beautiful. Where was it all these years? That's what the movie is. Actors who had that likability factor among the many. And moreover, the characteristics of Roy, the protagonist, the physical features, or for that matter, everything related to Roy quite resembled with what Chakuchin was. And when we happened to narrate the story to him, or rather when we happened to read the script out to him, he was very happy, he was very excited. All of us know this guy. Either he can be a neighbor or a cousin brother or somebody such as that. We all know him, and that's my catch. As for Nimisha, there was a time when we were seriously thinking about whom to cast for Clara, and that was when Tundimudal happened to get released. I saw visuals of the song Kannile Poi Geyle, which brought her to fame, and I was literally, the kind of warmth I felt for that artist was something which I'm sure all of you all would identify with. We are only trying to say one simple matter through this movie. We don't have so many things to say. It's just one simple thing. And it's a very simple, straightforward plot. So it was a huge challenge upon myself and Tony Madathil. Tony is the script writer, to make the screenplay the best, the most efficient, the most effective. And I find it, as a personally, I find such screenplays challenging. Tony was always in the game plan. It is the two of us who were going around for over 4 years, meeting directors and trying to make this movie happen. So Tony was always part of the struggle, the challenge. Then it was a matter of choosing your people. Like you said, the people whom I had to constantly interact with. So that's when I happened to do my short film on depression. The boy, I would call him boy because he's still a boy, who happened to edit my short film, seemed like a very comfortable person to work with. Somebody, though so young, seemed to have a lot of talent when it comes to people management, when it comes to his work on the edit table. Somebody who had a who had clarity regarding storytelling, I decided to go with Christy Sebastian. Then Dinnad Puthanjeri, son of the second son of late Sri Girish Puthanjeri, has penned four songs. The fifth song was penned by Mirshad. He's from Alua. My cinematographer was somebody who Chakuchan himself suggested. He had just finished shooting for Marpapa, Kuttanadan Marpapa, and Arvind Krishna had happened to work in that project. So they had a good rapport, and Chakuchan suggested, why not him? So we haven't met before, but because such a suggestion came up, we eventually met up. We had a meeting, and we found him to be a very, you know, considerate, and though quite senior, he was very understanding and very accommodating when it comes to, you know, accepting ideas and all of our energy. Because we were like, all of us were quite young, and we were like literally beaming with energy, and I think he had a tough time receiving all of it and settling us down, and then actually having to you know, work in sync and tandem with our energy. But he has done a tremendous work. Then one key man, my man, is definitely my chief associate director. His name is Ambro Varghese. He's a very promising future director. The first project I worked as a in cinema was as an assistant director was cinema company. So Ambro Satin was the chief associate director in that project. 8 years later, when I'm doing my debut, I couldn't think of anybody else for my chief associate director. And you know, if I were him, I would think, oh no, that guy or this girl worked under me 8 years back. Why would I wanna work under her now when she's gonna be the chief? I would think in those lines and respectfully back off. But this man literally bowled me out with his humility. I called him up and I asked him, Cheta, this is the scene, like, would you work with me? He said, I have another project. Give me 5 minutes, I'll call, cancel that and come with you. So that's the kind of affection or, you know, relationships you build when you work in this field. I am a 90s kid. There was still film, you know, the digital boom hadn't happened then. Movies used to be shot in film still. And the hit makers were Fazil sir and Sivi Malayil sir and Kamal sir and Satyanandikad and sorts, you know. I grew up on these movies. And as a 90s kid, you just can't stay out of that kind of art. How much ever you try to, your parents try to keep you away from movie. Because this is the quality, this is the kind of literature you get exposed to through the visual medium. You just get influenced. This whole storytelling process always intrigued me, excited me, and cinema kind of triggered it more. And at some point of time, I always knew this is what I wanted to do. By the time it was 2000, the millennium came into being. That is when I finished my 10th standard, and I joined college. I chose to join an engineering course. I wouldn't call myself an engineer because I am not. But I had a fantastic 4 years of campus life at CET, Trivandrum, and post which I was left with no other option but to work, make some money, and then do whatever you want. That is what my parents told me to do. So I worked for 4 years. I was at Bangalore. And by the time I knew I'll end up becoming a zombie, I decided to call it quits. I've had a very middle-class, simple upbringing. My parents, my father is from, both of them were government servants. My father is from Pathanamthitta, and my mother is from Kollam. I was born in Kollam and brought up mostly in Trivandrum. Schooling, college, all of that happened in Trivandrum. I had an elder brother, like three years back, he passed away. He was a very bright boy. My parents used to say that he was definitely, he was much more smarter than me. I wish he was alive, because if he were, I'm sure he would have been very excited about this coming September 20th.